You can meet your exes if you want.
What?
He'll not want.
Exes for a reason, right?
So tell me, what's the most dangerous thing that the other can do to irritate the other?
My look is very dangerous.
Yeah.
So according to him, he's wrong. According to me, when he's wrong, all I have to do is look at him very seriously.
No, it's not even fair to say that because she's always right.
And from monkey, it becomes Karan.
Yeah.
I say Karan. The only time I'm angry is, you know, when I'm dangerous, I say Karan. Otherwise, it's monkey.
Yeah.
And what about you?
Karan, I'm thinking, what did I do? What did I do? What did I do?
That's the worst, you know. It's the worst.
Yeah. Especially when you make a mistake, you should at least know what you did.
I'm just saying, Karan. Yeah. No wonder the song is apt for her, na?
Yeah.
Satnyana.
Yeah.
Very intense. And when I say Karan, it's very firm and very like intense.
I just so sometimes like, want to pretend it's not my name. I was like, I don't know who she's calling.
So what is it that you do that is dangerous for her? That dangerous thing you can do that would get her a little...
Oh, I can do many things to get her a little...
He does them less now, so it's okay.
Yeah.
If you can share one.
Moods.
Yeah.
He's a moody person.
Like, even though men are not...
Who said men?
Burdened with all the problems that women face. All the problems. We don't have even 1% of it. I don't think we would take 1% also of it. But we have, I mean, I've heard that other people also have a lot of mood swings.
My husband basically PMSs more than me.
It's true.
Yeah, that's a simple thing. He's trying to say it, but guma ke.
It's true.
But so, it's like our timing is also same. And I tell him, listen.
It's like a house sister.
You never give me a chance.
Yeah. Yeah, because you know, the thing is that then you realize that, yeah, man, you have to go through all of that. And I'm giving you grief about my mood. So it's like, where is the sand I want to put my head in now?
I think the Basu Grover house is nothing less than a circus, is it?
It is. It's very entertaining.
He entertains
me all the time. I'm just saying that I hear people like complaining about the lockdown, being with their families, being in their houses. I hear it all the time. I'm very grateful that I'm in the house with him all the time because we have had a good time. You know, we've used this time very, it's not that we are not affected by the world, but there are times, you know, when you have to draw the line and you have to cut all the negativity away because you can only preserve yourself. And then, you know, when this phase ends, we can all do our bit. But till then, preserving your sanity and learning something new, valuing the time, your partner, your home, everything. It's been quite an amazing growth as human beings for both of us.
There's only two ways to look at things today. Either you can wallow in the misery or you can grow from it. So we choose to grow.
Yeah.
And you have a movie coming in this lockdown, which is now a series, like it's broken into like 20 minute capsules. Yeah. So what was it like, Karan? Your position is not something all men would envy. Imagine the character you meet is your ex. It's not an enviable position.
If ex like this, you know, I don't know.
There is nobody like me.
Yeah, she's saying
you can meet your exes if you want.
What?
He'll not want.
Exes for a reason, right?
No. I don't mind. Couple of my exes are nice.
Yeah.
They're
I don't mind meeting some of your exes.
Yeah.
Maybe he'll have a gun hidden in the back pocket. Like.
Oh, him? No. He's okay. Yeah.
So tell us about Dangerous and Bipasha, you and playing the cop like a la Dhoom, you know.
It's not like Dhoom though. This time it's a Scotland Yard detective.
Wow.
She is, Dhoom was a little bit more fun being a cop, like in ganji and jeans and being more cool than doing actually anything. But here she's quite serious. She's good at her job. And she's in she's been put in this situation where she's in constant conflict because there was this guy who she loved, and now
she's
solving that particular case. Yeah, so it was interesting because I have been a tremendous fan of all the detective thrillers.
She's actually a detective in everything that we watch. She's solving it. We watch it, she solves it.
He always looks at me and he's like, baby, you're not supposed to solve it. And I'm like, you know, pata hai, iske baad, you know what's going to happen? Yeah. Adam, this one, this she guy
wants,
is wrong.
She wants to solve it before the ending. And
in-house Sherlock Holmes.
And I'm talking about every show, not everything. Just thrillers. I am cracking dramas.
Everything.
Wow.
So I'm a wannabe detective. She's so I got to be a detective. So I got happy. Because I've been such big fan of all these female protagonist shows, whether it's The Fall or
Killing Eve.
And the best, what's that one? Marcella. I love those shows. And I love those ladies. So I was like, wow. It is a female detective's role. I'm excited to play it. It's not like them, but it's very different. But it's fun. It was interesting.
What about you, Karan?
Oh, yeah. it was fun for me that she was playing the female detective.
But your character, a man caught in that dilemma.
Yeah. It's an intense character. Also, yeah. it's not one-dimensional. Because he's someone who's come from the streets and he's done everything on his own and he's reached at a particular place by making a lot of sacrifices. And he'll do whatever it takes to be in that position and try and not say too much more about the film. The series.
We'll watch it. So what about the thriller genre? Both of you seem to be a little partial towards that genre, isn't it? I mean, Bipasha was thriller and horror. And yeah, and you said somewhere that you love the thriller genre.
No.
It's an interactive genre. It's very captivating for the audiences because you're always guessing. With every twist and turn, you're always guessing. So you're a little bit like Bipasha Basu watching. You're also a detective. So, so it's a genre which I've always liked to watch and also definitely be a part of because the characters are, not just unidimensional. There's lots happening in a particular film or now series. So I've been partial, though I've done all kind of genres, but I'm definitely partial to thrillers, always.
What about you, Ben?
So am I. I mean, I think it's the pace that kind of interests me.
Yeah, it's
because
quick.
There's no time to for your mind to make up something else because you're watching or you're playing. So it's the pace of it is what gets me.
And 5 years ago, you met on the sets of Alone and now working together. Is it easier when, working together?
You go to set like an actor first and definitely you do not burden the project or with the fact that you are a couple. Like somebody asked me, so now you have a lot to prove as a couple through this show. I don't even understand that. I have done this show as Bipasha Basu. He's done it as Karan Singh Grover. And the way we choose our work is as individuals, we've liked the project. He was signed on first. They wanted me to hear it. I was not keen because I believe that we should not be always working together.
Always want more keen.
Keep it. But he does.
I get a lot of brownie points, huh?
Yeah.
It's true. No,
this is the thing. See him, the way he is, they'll think always I'm some mean person because he's oversweet. That's the problem.
See?
It's not that I'm mean.
There is such a thing.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So what were you saying? I forgot.
You were saying that you signed later.
Yeah, I signed afterwards. And when we come on set, he would definitely give me the respect and space of the actor that I am.
Everyone does. She's a fire-breathing dragon.
No, not that I'm demanding, but breathing fire.
No, you command respect. Anything like that.
It's nice, because I could be the way I am always on set with him. And the wife kicks in only after pack-up. Till then, it's Bipasha Basu, the actor. Karan Singh Grover, the actor. Karan Singh Grover, who is very naughty on sets. For some serious scenes, I have to make eyes. Karan, please.
Yeah, I'll ask the
Please keep quiet.
I'll ask the assistant directors and ask, has she reached? So then yeah. maybe like, yeah, I was like, okay, fine.
So also I'm like very particular with time. So because we have to leave from the same room for the first time with a co-star, it's like weird.
Particular is a very, very, yeah.
So I'm like, Karan, are you ready? We have to leave at this time. You better be ready. I'm not going to be waiting. Otherwise, I'll take my car and go.
I actually started waking up at 5 because of that. I wake up at 5
every
day.
Yeah, he wakes up at 5 every day.
And I realized now, what I was thinking about, it's all because of her.
Wow.
Because if I wake up at 5, then I can...
Catch up.
Otherwise,
my speed.
Wow. But you know what you said, fire breathing dragon. I mean, you know, the thing is now we are talking about narratives being written for women, heroines wanting to do other work. But Bipasha, weren't you one of those first people, one of the, you know, few in the time who broke the stereotype of the typical Hindi film heroine?
Yeah.
Your movies like Corporate, you know, whether it was Raaz, Jism. Yeah. And I remember a lot of people gave you flak saying, Jism can't be your first debut, but yeah. you went ahead and did it. Yeah. And now when you see all this, you couldn't be boxed then. And is it the same Bipasha now?
Well, now I'm just feeling that it's such a wonderful time to be an actor. Because everyone is out of their boxes. The thing is, there is no... earlier, there used to be like, actresses are supposed to look like this. Actress is supposed to be of this specific age. These kind of roles are only going to be written for, you know, after 25, you are literally dead.
Yeah.
If you are more than 25, you are dead. It used to be as bad as that. But it's amazing that in today's time, people are writing roles for age irrespective. Boxes irrespective, people are free to write interesting stories, interesting characters. Actors have the freedom to play them without being put in boxes again. So it's a very good time. And I think also I've relaxed quite a bit after my wedding. And I was like, acha, kuch mahine mein karte hain. Ah, karti hu. Abhi I'll start listening to stories. And I didn't know that so much time has passed, but now I'm totally ready and I'm ready to listen to all these fabulous roles that are being written for women. And, you know, there are platforms which are, people are consuming this content so happily. The numbers are so strong and it's very, very good. Whether it's my other actresses who have done a couple of these, like I saw Sushmita's Arya, commendable, like really great show. Like Ram Madhvani has done superlatively. All the characters were good. She was fantastic. So I feel very proud that, you know, and that the fact that I want to, like, again, you know, get onto the bandwagon of acting and relaxing a bit less at a good time. This is a good time for being an actor, even a female actor.
I remember when Jason came out, everybody kept telling her, aapko aise hi role milenge. And then she kept doing different stuff. You know, there was Ajnabi, you gave us a role.
But this business can try and push you into this. See, when the Supernatural phase started, you know, I really had to battle it. Like, I was saying no to Alone again and again because it was like Supernatural only was coming my way. There was nothing else for some time. And I was not even listening to them because I wanted to break it. And then Kumar Mangal is like, aap kyun aisa kar rahe ho? Aap sun to lo story. Because there's a good human drama to it. And the moment I heard it, I was like, oh my God, it's very interesting as an actor and a story.
Yeah.
So what if it's a Supernatural? Let me pick it up. So it's you have to, like even with like for After Alone, it was like, I didn't want to work. And then everything was only like, aap dono saath mein kaam karo, aap dono saath mein kaam karo. Everything becomes very like a pattern in this business.
True.
So you have to really be very stubborn and stick to your guts and like wait for the thing to happen at the right time.
And Karan, your journeys have been very different. What about you? You're also extremely choosy about the kind of roles you're picking up, you know? So what's your process?
My process is only based on my growth of the art that I'm in. And if I feel that I can choose a project where there is some amount of growth or some another dimension that I can add to myself as an actor, then I would do that. Otherwise, there's no point doing the same thing over and over again because I get bored very fast with things and I can't do one thing at one time. I need to do like lots of things.
True.
He's also an artist, you know, Pooja. His art is like really amazing. He's like a professional artist. We were going to have the exhibition just before the lockdowns on 16th, and it didn't happen.
Starinfinityart.com.
So if you just see it, starinfinityart.com.
Awesome.
See his stuff. We are tied with some curators. Everything is like, it was like about to happen and we are in the lockdown. But the gallery has opened and everything is online. Things are moving. And he's got a big thumbs up from all the art lovers. So that's why he creates every day. There's not been one day in the lockdown that he's not created.
And it started because of her, actually.
Wow.
So he's an excellent artist.
Yeah. She's, as I say, muse to many.
Yeah.
And now it's amazing. Now people were talking about, you know, fairness creams and all, not realizing that back in the day, you were one of the few who refused to endorse fairness creams.
Yes.
Yeah,
absolutely. I'm actually one of those who have gone up to other fellow actors who were endorsing and such intelligent human beings. And I have told them, why are you doing this? Because there's your fan following. You shouldn't do this. It sends the wrong signal to an already completely lost country who's lost behind fairness, looking for fair. It's good. It's a very big step, you know, from a company as big as that to at least this is like a beginning for change.
No, it was about time, about 20 years ago, man. They're very late. They should just understand where they are and do it now.
The noises now, didn't realize that the little whispers had started during her time because, you know.
Yeah.
Also, are you happy with the OTT platform? People say it's far more democratic for talent, a lot of, because, you know, the way the film industry is.
Yeah.
You've been part of it. You know how it works.
Yeah.
And so do you think it's a far more democratic platform? You're not burdened by box office and everyone gets an equal footing. Do you think so?
See, I feel that our film industry has evolved every year. And democratic in the sense, like I said, there are no limitation in today's time for creative people to write because there's no censorship and like no limitations for even actors. And there is no particular look. Now it's not ki, this is the heroine, this is the hero. You can look like anything and act. And that's amazing because so many more people are getting work. And there's so many platforms creating so much content with so many actors. So I think it's a very, very good time for actors. It's like, it's something which it's just going to boom even more. I know that sooner or later, everything like the theaters will open and everything will happen, but there is definitely going to be much more content and OTTs are only going to grow. They are the future. Yeah.
What about you, Karan? You do a lot of television as well.
Everything has been moving towards being digital for some time. I mean, it was a natural progression for anything and everything. Even people buying things online and watching things online. So I think it reduces the limitations for an actor reaching his or her audience because now they don't have to finish from work early or bunk a day of school or not go somewhere and not give enough importance to their own thing and get entertained. So now they can do everything.
And their time.
Yeah, and we can... It's like a connect between the audience and the actor at all times. So there are no distances anymore.
So, Bipasha, will you see a lot more of you? Have you like entered the Banvas after? You know?
It's just that last month I woke up to it and I was like, I called my manager and was like, okay, let's fix meetings, even virtual ones right now, not face to face, but virtual meetings and let's just start reading.
5 years long break. Now you've,
I never thought it's 5 years, Pooja.
Yeah.
Everyone said, telling me now so I know. So because I didn't count, I was really living. It was important. I needed to spend time with my husband, my family.
You were 16, yeah.
Yeah, my family is something I really have missed that life, you know, of being with family all the time. And I'm a very family-oriented girl. So I have enjoyed because my father retired immediately after my wedding. And he's a workaholic. And so we got a lot of time together, the entire family. And it's amazing.
Awesome. Yeah.
It's the only thing I miss, actually.
Yeah, that's the one thing that we miss is our Sunday fam jams, which we go to my mom's house. And that's what we are not doing because we are trying to give, you know, we don't want to go and expose our parents to anything. So we see them on phone every day. Yeah.
So anyways, before we wrap up, lockdown confessions from both. Who cooks the best meal at home?
Me. He doesn't cook only.
I eat the best meal at home.
Yeah, awesome. He eats it.
Who's the most social amongst the two of you?
I am more social.
Okay. Who's the funniest?
And I am not very social to other people.
Yeah.
They will laugh at me when I'm saying I'm more social.
No, in
and
comparison.
They will look at me, they'll like, you?
In comparison, because like I know like all in all five people. So.
Yeah.
Who's the funniest?
He. But I'm funny without knowing.
No, dude. If I show you some videos that I have, of course.
Shut up.
I will be making a gazillion rupees every day.
No, so there are times.
So funny. So funny.
I don't think before I speak. So I make a lot of those pop-ups. Like those are horrible ones I do.
No, that's just.
Especially when I speak in Hindi sometimes.
That's called the Sardar effect.
Yeah. Bad one. Yeah.
Who does the most household work?
What?
Who does? Yeah.
The who does? Yeah, I don't do any.
I do.
I if my with my whole heart and soul, if I try, I reach 0.1%. So.
One thing that you've discovered about
without fail, I don't think there's anybody who's as lucky as me. I have got a foot massage for half an hour every night throughout the lockdown.
Wow.
See, this is something, and now he has told me it's for life. It started in the lockdown. So I tell him, I feel very guilty. I said, baby, should I press your back or something? He's like, no, just relax. So so I'm going to get this foot massage apparently for life, told me. So it's not just for the lockdown. But that's something new. And really, I feel very, very blessed.
Mother, grateful. All the other times I'm quite useless. So might as well,
rubbish.
Add some value.
Man, you're really goals. Yeah, you're setting up really high standards. All women would want now. Clones of Karan.
True, but all my closest best friends, like when they didn't know Karan, and after some time when they knew Karan, they love him. My girlfriends love Karan. Like so, yeah.
Yeah.
Ladies do want.
What is that one thing that you've discovered about each other that you didn't know before in the lockdown?
No, we spend a lot of time together. Even without lockdown, we love spending time with each other. So we completely know each other. So nothing different in the lockdown, but individually, there's a lot that I've got to know about myself. I've given myself a little more time in the lockdown. There's a lot of self-care process that I'm going through.
Yeah.
And that's really, that's for me to become a better person. And that's the space he gives me. That, when he doesn't disturb me, my morning routine and my meditation and rituals, he doesn't disturb me at all. He wants me to get all the time in the world for me to take care of myself. Yeah.
My life revolves around growth. So if there's things that she's doing for her growth, it's my responsibility to make sure that she has
it. And I have learned it from him only. All this spiritual, he's more spiritual than me.
Okay.
Like in our house, he does the puja every day. My mother had this dream that shank, in Bengalis, we blow the conch after puja. My mother wanted the daughters to do it, but none of the daughters do it. But she says, Karan mera beta. So he blows the conch.
Well, she actually wished for
when my mother was pregnant with me, she always thought she's going to have a son and she's going to name him Karan. And when my mother was pregnant with my younger sister, she wanted again a Karan. And she's also married to a Karan.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
So my mother said that I have manifested it. So she used to say, Mera Karan aega, Mera Karan aega, Karan aega.
So I told her, Ma, aapka connection na, wo galat jagah pe lag gaya wahan pe.
But she says, Mujhe dekho, mil gaya Mera Karan beta, mujhe mil gaya. He's not my damad, he's my beta.
Awesome.
Yeah.
And anyways, both of your fitness goals, can you give us, our viewers, some tips about how to be fit mentally, which a lot of today, we need to emphasize on the mental health as well, mentally and physically, tips from the fittest couple I've known.
And start with a 5 minutes at least of meditation. Give importance to your mind, because if your mind is not in control or mind is not healthy, your body cannot be healthy. It's together. They have to be healthy. So start, even however boring it might be, listen to you know, guided meditations, or start doing a chant, or do breathing exercises. There are many kinds of meditation. So see what works for you. It's very important to figure it out, because I'm also in the process of finding it. And I have found a lot of things, and many things are beneficial. So everything is out there digitally in today's time. It's not that you have to go somewhere to learn it or understand it. You have to just start. And once you do it for like 21 days, it becomes a habit and you will feel it. So this one is the person who is spiritual, and I am just now understanding all of it, what he tells me.
Yeah, that's because you're born a six-dimensional being, so you don't really need to learn
anything. Give them.
But the thing is, for people who are just starting, I think it's very important for them to do some sort of workout before they meditate. Because what happens is, meditation will calm you down and it'll bring you back to yourself. But if you're not used to working out, that doesn't last very long. So, and there's a chemical endorphin.
Being physically active, you have to be definitely doing something for your body. And body weight training,
up and down
or
the stairs,
yoga,
man.
You don't need equipment. You don't need to spend money. All you need is a mat, maybe maximum. That's your investment.
Or a sofa.
He doesn't need a mat also. He needs sofa furniture. He's doing anything. He's adapting. I'm just saying that you can't give yourself an excuse ki mere paas gym nahi hai. Yeah, it's too expensive. Or and eat healthy, you know. And eating healthy means have dal, chawal, sabzi. Eating healthy does not mean that you have to eat the most expensive so-called health foods in today's time.
Organic.
We eat dal, chawal, sabzi. And we turned vegetarian last 5 months. I have come back to eating fish. He's vegan now.
Okay.
So, but it's our nutrition is in the kind of food that we eat and the spices that we have, you know. So imbibe and embrace the Indian in you, and you will stay very sturdy and strong and healthy.
Thank you so much, guys. And since it's dangerous, but a word of advice to couples out there from the couple who's giving us goals now. Just one word of advice, because a lot of couples are tearing into each other's headspace also as of now.
It's very sad, you know. I don't understand it, because I've also heard this a lot. I'm just feeling that in a, you know, the kind of lives we lead, there's anyway so little time to give to your partner. This should have been a time of blessing where you make your relationship go to another level and work on it and spend time and make memories, because this life is a gift. It's only this one life, and time just keeps going. So if you don't make every day beautiful, it's just like, you know, it's gone. That day is gone.
And going to another level and making everything beautiful is not only about realizing that this is my life. If there is a problem that people face with each other at a time when they're together, then that's a serious problem. Like, you can understand maybe that somewhere along the line you've made a mistake. Doesn't mean that you have to keep making the same mistake your whole life.
Work on it.
Yeah, either work on it or realize that you made
a mistake.
Yeah, and move on. And that's the only way you grow.
Thank you so much, guys. All the very best for Dangerous. And I hope to see you, lady, more often on screen now.
I promise. Soon, soon again.
Thank you so much. Be safe. And thank you so much. Keep inspiring.
You too. Lots of love.
Bye. Take care.
Bye.
Lots of love. Bye.